artistic director of the National Chorale, and I would like to welcome you to the 53rd annual Messiah Sing-In. The Messiah Sing-In at Lincoln Center was created as a celebration of choral singing and is today one of New York's most popular holiday season events. Our sing-in audiences include 3,000 singers of all backgrounds who come from throughout New York City, the greater New York, New Jersey, Connecticut areas, across the United States, and indeed from countries around the world, all singing Handel's great masterpiece together. At Lincoln Center, the audience is the chorus. The Messiah Sing-In was conceived and developed in 1967 by Martin Joslin, the founder of the National Chorale. The first Messiah Sing-In took place on Friday evening, December 13, 1967. It was an immediate success and has continued as a joyous, traditional choral singing event at Lincoln Center. Of course, this year we're not at Lincoln Center. We are virtual, and we are delighted that you are joining us. Our soloists this year are Brittany-Renee-Robinson, soprano, Jessica-Grigg, mezzo, tenor, Albert-Rudolph-Lee, and Keith Harris, baritone. We also welcome James-Wentzel as our organist for this evening's performance. All of the soloists and the conductors have been working to try to make this a very special evening for you. I've asked the conductors to provide some materials from previous years, and some of the conductors have also created new material for this performance. One final request, we'd like for you to sing along. As you know, for 52 years, this has been a sing-along, so why change it in year 53? If you don't have a score, just go to our website, nationalchorale.org, and download a score. Or, if you have a score, please feel free to sing along. We will begin with the overture by James-Wentzel, and then we will proceed through Messiah. We hope that you enjoy this experience, and we hope that you sing heartily.
40.
Oh,
crooked straight, the crooked straight, the crooked straight, and the rough places plain, and the rough places plain, and the rough places plain. The crooked straight and the rough places plain.
A little while, and I will shake the heavens and the earth, the sea and the dry land, and I will shake, and I will shake. All nations I'll shake. The heavens, the earth, the sea, the dry land, the nations, a shake. And what is higher of all nations shall come. For lord whom ye seek shall certainly come to his temple, even the messenger of the covenant whom ye delight in. Behold, he shall come, saith the Lord of hosts. When he appeareth, who shall stand? When he appeareth, but who may abide? But who may abide the day of his coming? And who shall stand when he appeareth? And who shall stand when he appeareth? And when he appeareth, but who may abide the day of his coming? And who shall stand? And who shall stand when he appeareth? When he appeareth? For he is like a refiner's fire, like a refiner's fire. And who shall stand when he appeareth? And who shall stand when he appeareth? For he is like a refiner's fire. And who shall stand when he appeareth? When he appeareth? For he is like a refiner's fire. For he is like a refiner's fire.
Thank you. Hi, I'm Judy Reinerson, and I am honored to serve as chair of the National Chorale Board. I'm going to keep this short because I know you can't wait to get back to hearing and singing more beautiful music, but I did want to tell you just a little something about the National Chorale. This is an amazing organization, New York City's longest serving professional ensemble. And in addition to doing amazing, beautiful performances of great choral works, the National Chorale has also been teaching New York City's kids at New York City public schools, kids of all ages. And it's really a tribute to the chorale and what it does to New York City and what it means to New York City. Now, none of this would have been possible if it hadn't been for the amazing visionary leadership of our founder, Martin Josemann, who passed in 2014. And although he is terribly missed, we know that he has left an imprint on the city of New York many times over, and how he has led the ensemble and the city in amazing choral music. Now, since 2014, we have been led by our inspirational music conductor, Everett McCorvey. And, you know, we just love Everett. He is terrific. And he, together with Amy Siegler, really get a huge amount of credit for transforming the National Chorale from its New York City roots to being a truly international organization. Bravo, Everett and Amy. And we're just so happy and excited and thrilled to have him leading us. Now, last but not least, I wanted to mention that this particular piece, the Messiah Singing, is important because there's nothing more soul-nourishing than singing. And while it's wonderful to watch and see other people sing, singing it yourself and being able to sing along, that is magical. And one of the hardest things about being in this terrible pandemic is those of us who are in choral groups and love to sing, is we cannot sing in groups. It's just, you can't do it, it's too dangerous. And that's why today's virtual Messiah Singing is so important, because now you all, and I too, can sing and join this fabulous piece of music from the comfort of our homes. I hope you all sing your hearts out. I know I'm gonna be doing it too. So thank you and enjoy.
Thank you. Good evening. My name is Amy Siegler. I'm the executive director of the National Chorale, and I'm so delighted that you could be here with us to celebrate National Chorale's 53rd annual Handel's Messiah Singing. As you know, we've been a leader in education and music in New York City for 53 years, and we're so proud to continue this tradition even in these uncertain times. Our excellence in education continues with our vocal program partnership at the Professional Performing Arts School, now in its 11th year. and we continue to make music with our professional musicians to keep choral music and the cultural arts alive. But of course, we can't do it without your help. We appreciate all of your continued support. Please visit us at our website, www.nationalchorale.org, and please consider your tax-free contribution to help keep the National Chorale continue its tradition of excellence in music education and performance for years to come. Thank you again for joining us, and I hope you enjoy the rest of the evening.
Thank you. him to scorn. They shoot out their lips and shake their heads, saying,
we trust in you.
unto which of the angels said he at any time, Thou art my song, this day have I begotten thee.
Shall sound, and the dead shall be raised, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible. The trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be incorruptible, and we shall be changed, and we shall be changed. Trumpet shall sound, the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised, be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed, be changed, and we shall changed, and we shall be changed. We shall be changed, and we shall be changed, and we shall be changed, and we shall be changed, we shall be changed, and we shall be changed, we shall.
Thank you.
you so much for joining us this evening. And thanks to our soloists and our organists and our wonderful conductors and choirs. We had a great time. We hope that you did too. If you want to know more about National Chorale, please access our website at www.nationalchorale.org. We hope next year that we will be able to present this concert in person at Lincoln Center. And more importantly, we hope that you will be able to join us. Thank you so much, and on behalf of the staff at the National Chorale and all of the artists that we have the opportunity to represent, we hope that you have a joyous holiday season, and we will see you next year.